The Faith I Live By, a devotional by Ellen G. White.
Bright beams of glory. And his brightness was as the light. He had bright beams out of his side, and there was the hiding of his power. Habakkuk chapter 3, verse 4. Satan, by means of his success in turning man aside from the path of obedience, became the god of this world. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4. The dominion that once was Adam's passed to the usurper. But the Son of God proposed to come to this earth to pay the penalty of sin, and thus not only redeem man, but recover the dominion forfeited. The Apostle Paul has referred to it, the restoration of the lost dominion, as the redemption of the purchased possession. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 14. Not only man, but the earth had by sin come under the power of the wicked one, and was to be restored by the plan of redemption. The cross of Calvary, while it declares the law immutable, proclaims to the universe that the wages of sin is death. In the Savior's expiring cry, "It is finished," the death knell of Satan was rung. The great controversy which had been so long in progress was then decided, and the final eradication of evil was made certain. The Son of God passed through the portals of the tomb, that through death he might destroy him that had the power of death, that is, the evil. Hebrews chapter 2, verse 14. Lucifer's desire for self-exaltation had led him to say, "I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will be like the Most High." Isaiah chapter 14, verses 13 and 14. God declares, "I will bring thee to ashes upon the earth, and never shalt thou be any more." Ezekiel chapter 28, verses 18 and 19. "I saw a new heaven and a new earth." Revelation chapter 21, verse 1. "Every trace of the curse is swept away." One reminder alone remains. Our Redeemer will ever bear the marks of his crucifixion. Upon his wounded head, upon his side, his hands and feet are the only traces of the cruel work that sin has wrought. Says the prophet, beholding Christ in his glory, "He had bright beams coming out of his side, and there was the hiding of his power." The cross of Christ will be the signs and the song of the redeemed through all eternity.